Good morning to all of you. Am I audible?
Yes, sir.
Okay. Okay. So we'll continue algorithm. Now next is parent selection. So parent selection, it is done based on the fitness function. Okay, so there are several methods for this parent selection. Out of that, we have already discussed Rowlett-Weil selection, how to do that thing. But again, it is summarized here. After fitness function evaluation, individuals are distinguished based on their quality. Quality means here the fitness function. So if it is a maximization problem, then the value of the fitness function, which is maximum, will be taken as the, will be selected from the population. Okay. Similarly, if it is a minimization function, so the particular value of the objective function, which is minimum, that will be chosen from the population. Okay. So best one will be selected. Now, according to the Darwin's evolution theory, the best one should survive and create new offspring for the next generation. So that is basically survival for the fittest. Okay. So those who are fittest, they will be they survive for the next population. There are many methods to select the best chromosomes. One is the first one is the Rowlett-Weil selection, then Boltzmann selection, then tournament selection, rank selection, and steady state selection. So there are several methods by which we can actually select this population. Now, Rowlett-Weil selection, parents are selected according to their fitness. That is, each individual is selected with a probability proportional to its fitness value. So in this case, there will be based on the fitness value, the parents are selected. And here the probability is proportional to the fitness value. In other words, depending on the percentage contribution to the total population fitness, string is selected for mating to form the next generation. So how this next population will be formed based on the selection. Okay, selection will be done again, the value of the fitness. So the best fitness value will be chosen from the population. This way, the weak solutions are eliminated and strong solutions survive to form the next generation. So for example, consider a population containing 4 strings. So here you see these are the candidate. These are the candidate and their fitness value, it is given 109, 76, 50, 153. So the percentage of the total fitness, so it is total fitness value is 388. So if you take 108 by 388, it will be 28.09. Similarly, 76 by 388, it is 19.59. 50 by 388, it is 12.89. And 153 by 388, it is 39.43. Okay. So this way, actually, the total percentage of total fitness, it is calculated. Now, each string is formed by concatenating 4 substrings, which represent variable A, B, C, D. So these are the basically variables, A, B, C, D, some variables are there in this particular, any problem. Okay, let us say any problem is there and we have chosen 4 variables and they are represented by 4 bit representation. Length of each string is taken as 4 bits. The first column represents the possible solution in the binary form. So these are the basically your possible solution. So this possible solution, X1, X2, this is X3, this is the X3 column and this is the X4 column. Based on this, there is an objective function. Objective function may be x1 square plus x2 square plus x3 square plus x4 square, anything, any function may be given. And based on that particular fitness, based on that particular value, we'll substitute this candidate value. x1 equal to here, we can calculate, we can convert this binary to decimal, then x2, then x3, then x4. So we can substitute those value and we can calculate the fitness. And then finally, what is the percentage of the total fitness can be calculated. So the second column gives the fitness values of the decoded string. So that is the basically fitness value of the decoded string. So we'll substitute all these x1, x2, x3, x4 values in the objective function, and from there we'll calculate the fitness value. The third column gives the percentage contribution of each string to the total fitness of the population. So what is the percentage contribution of each string to the total fitness of the population that can be calculated? Then by Rowlett field method, the probability of candidate one being selected as parent of the next generation, that is 28.09. So we have calculated that these are the basically percentage of the total fitness. So from here we can see this is the best one. Okay, if it is a maximization problem, then it is the best one. Okay. Then similarly, the probability that the candidates 2, 3, 3, 4 will be selected for the next generation are 19.59, 12.89, and 39.43 respectively. We can calculate. These probabilities are represented on a pie chart. Then four numbers are randomly generated between 1 to 100. Then the likeliness that the numbers generated would fall in the region of the candidate 2 might be once, whereas the candidate 4, it might be twice, and candidate 1 more than once, and for candidate 3, it may not fall at all. So thus the strings are chosen to form the parents of the next generation. So basically, based on the, we'll form a Rowlett field. So we have seen that thing, that how to choose that particular Rowlett field. Now here we have to check that whether the this particular population, this particular string will be selected or not. That is basically dependent on the fitness value. So if the fitness value is good, then we can select that particular candidate. If the fitness is not good, so then we'll not choose that particular candidate for the next population. So what is the criteria? That is the fitness. So fitness, how we are choosing that the best fitness will be chosen first. So in this case, you see the percentage of total fitness is calculated. So first this candidate will be selected, then the next candidate will be the first one. So the chances of selection for this particular, with the help of this Rowlett field selection, it will be candidate 4 will be selected first, then the candidate 1. So this way we actually will proceed for the next population. Is it clear that how the selection is done? Is it clear? Is it clear that how the selection process is actually executed? Hello. Hello.
Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
Okay. So I will proceed to next. So next is the choice of methods of selecting chromosome. So that is basically what are the basically methods for selecting the chromosome. First is the population diversity, and second is the selection pressure. So population diversity is the good ones exploited, but new areas are exploited, but it is slow. But selective pressure, better individuals are better preferred, but chance of getting local maximum or minimum, but it is a faster method. So there are two kinds of methods for selecting the chromosome. One is the population diversity. Now population diversity means we will explore new population, but in this case, there is a problem. The problem is we will be exploring the new population, whether that population will be good or bad, we don't know. And this method is basically a slow method. Whereas the selective pressure method, it is a better individuals will be generated. Okay. But the problem here is that chance of getting the local optima will be here, that there is a chance. But this is a comparatively faster method. Now next we'll see that what is the meaning of this generation. Generation is the population of the design vector obtained after one computation on all individuals. So we have seen that how this generation will come. Okay, generation means here you see. If you see this thing, this is the, let us say, the first generation. So next generation, the offspring will be created. So those offspring will be how that will be selected. That is based on the Rowlett field selection method. So how the generation will come, it is basically after running that particular algorithm for one times. So the next generation, the offspring will be created. Now, what is the generation gap? Now, the proportion of individuals in the population that are replaced in each generation should be increased to improve the result. Now, you see, generation gap means in the first generation, let us say you have the set of variables. Set of variables means those are the basically probable solutions. So those probable solutions after the selection operator or the maybe the mutation operator, maybe the crossover operator, you are generating a better and better offspring. So when you are generating better and better offspring, so there will be a difference between whatever the you have the value in the first generation and whatever you are getting in the next generation, there will be a difference of that. So this difference is basically known as the generation gap. So proportion of the individuals in the population that are replaced in each generation, it should be increased to improve the result. So that means in each generation, it is desirable that the basically the population should get increased, means the value of the fitness function should get improved. Next is the reproduction. Reproduction generally, after choosing a method of selection population with above average fitness function in one generation are taken as parents and inserted in the next population in multiple clones so that a good trait is transferred to the child. So reproduction means in the how we are actually generating the offspring in the next population. So that generation of the offspring in the next population, it depends on that there are various methods. One is the maybe your selection method, there may be a crossover method, there may be a mutation method. So those methods are there. And based on those methods, we can actually generate a better offspring or better child. And so those offsprings will have a good trait, good characteristic in the next generation. Now, next we'll discuss that what is the crossover. So crossover, it is a recombination operator. It is a recombination. We'll see that how the crossover is done. We have discussed it, but in detail, we'll discuss here. Selection alone cannot introduce any new individuals into the population, and it cannot find new points in the search space. See, when we are selecting it, why this statement is coming, I will discuss this thing. Let us say you have a variable x1, x2, x3, and x4. Let us say you are representing with the help of 4-bit representation. 1, 0, 1, 1, this is 0, 1, 1, 1. This is, let us say, 1, 1, 0, 1, and this is 0, 1, 0, 1. This is, let us say, 1, 1, 1, 0. This is 1, 1, 0, 0. This is 1, 0, 1, 1. This is 1, 0, 0, 1. This is, let us say, these are the possible solutions. Initially you are assuming it. 1, 0, 1, 1. This is, let us say, 0. And 1, 0, 1, 1. This is 1, 1, 0, 0. This is 1, 1, 0, 0, let us say. And let us say the fitness you have calculated, that is, let us say, 104. There's, let us say here it is 112, it is 88, like that. So now you see in the selection process, what actually we are doing. Selection process, we are selecting chromosomes based on their fitness value, So that means better fitness, it means chances of selection in next population will be more or it is less.
More, sir.
It will be more. So that means here you can see here the best one, if it is a maximization problem, this will be selected fast. The chances of selection will be fast. This will be your second and this will be your third. So when you are generating the next population, okay, that time this one will be selected fast. So that means here, whatever things it is there in the chromosome, it will be directly copied. Okay, this will be, there will not be change in the characteristic of the chromosome, because as it is, it will be copied. Similarly, the second one, if you have the second one, have the choice, so then this will be chosen in the second chance. Okay, so that means individually, the character wise, this character, the chromosome character, it will not be changed. It will be directly copied. So in case of selection, there will be a chromosome will be best chromosomes. Let us say best chromosomes will be selected, or it is copied in next population. So that means what will happen? Chances of new trait, it will be less or more? Chances of new trait, new characteristic will be more or it will be less? It will be less.
Less.
Because we are choosing the same chromosome. We are not changing within the chromosome. We are not doing anything on the chromosome. Okay. So now we'll go back to the slide. So we have seen that in case of selection, there is no such characteristic it is introduced. It is basically copied. Yes, we are choosing the population from the parents. Okay. But here the point is, that we are not introducing any new characteristic, new traits in the population. Okay, so selection alone cannot introduce any new individuals into the population. That is, it cannot find new points in the search space. So we cannot find it. These are generated by genetically inspired operators, of which the most well known are crossover and mutation. So yes, we can introduce the new trait, we can introduce the new characteristic with the help of some genetically inspired operators. Those operators are basically, we can have crossover, we can have mutation. So we'll see that how the new characteristic, new traits are introduced, which is not present in case of a selection. So if you are performing the selection, in that case, there is no chance of your new characteristic, new trait. But if you have the crossover and mutation, yes, the new characteristic and new traits will be introduced. So how it is done, we'll see. So the types of crossover, what are the different types of crossover it is there? Because first one is the 1-point crossover, then 2-point, then uniform, then arithmetic, then heuristic, then matrix. So these are the different kinds of crossover it is there. Now we'll first discuss that what is the 1-point crossover. Now 1-point crossover means there is a single point. You have a bit representation of the chromosome. It may be a 4-bit, it may be 8-bit, like that, for example. And those bits will be actually represented with the help of binary numbers. Now, when you are actually performing this crossover at that time, at least there will be two points or two chromosomes will be selected. Because unless there is a two chromosome, the crossover will not happen. For a single chromosome, the crossover cannot happen. This is a crossover. Crossover means basically change of the characteristic. Okay, the basically swapping of the characteristic. So how it is done, we'll see that. In 1-point crossover, selected pair of strings is cut at some random position and their segments are swapped to form new pair of strings. So here you see, this is one given string, which is a parent, and this is another parent. Now let us say the crossover is done from at this point. Okay, at this point means from the third bit. So if there is a crossover from the third bit, so what will happen? Whatever the bit properties it is there in the chromosome 1, it will be copied to chromosome 2. And whatever property it is there under the chromosome 2, after this bit 3, it will be copied into chromosome 1. So, it is from the first to third. It will be first to third. Up to this point, we are doing the crossover. So that means whatever property it is there for the first chromosome, that is first parent, from first bit to third bit, it will be copied into the parent 2. Okay, that will be copied to the parent 2 in the next generation. And similarly, when let us say in case of this chromosome 2, whatever the characteristic it is there, bit characteristic it is there under the chromosome 1, it will be copied into the parent 2, which will be reflected in the chromosome 2. So you see here from 1 to 3, it was red. And this was basically, this color. Okay, so that means that we are copying this color to here. Okay, and as it is, from 4th and 5th, it will be as it is. Similarly, this is copied here, the red one is copied here, and this color is kept as it is. So that means what we are getting in the next population, next chromosome, okay, the next offspring, that is we are having some different kinds of characteristics. So let us say if it is a 111, so when, and it is a, let us say 011, so this 011 is copied here. So that means ultimately your bit characteristic, it is now changed, okay. I will just elaborate this thing once more here. So for example, let us say we have a bit characteristic something in terms of binary 1101, this is 1011. This is your parent one, for example. And this is a, let us say 1010111010. This is parent two. Now here the crossover operation is done. Now when we are doing this crossover operation, this particular, let us say we are doing crossover from fourth bit. Okay. So first to fourth bit. Okay. First to fourth. So when we are doing this crossover from first to fourth bit, so in the next generation, what will happen? This particular property will be copied here and this particular property will be copied here. So that means this will be 1010 and the remaining things will be same. This is 1011 and similarly here, what will happen? This will be copied. That is 1101, it is copied and this is 1110. So this is your offspring one, this is your offspring one and this is your offspring two. This is basically your single point crossover, single point. Is it clear? Any doubt?
Yes, sir, clear.
Okay, fine. Now next. So in 2-point scheme, there will be 2 breakpoints in the scheme that are randomly chosen. See, these particular thing, which bit will be selected from which bit to which bit? 1 point, maybe a single bit will be selected. For 2 point, which from which bit to which bit this particular crossover will be done. This is randomly chosen. Okay, randomly chosen in the problem. Okay, so at the breakpoint, the segments of the two strings are swapped so that new set of strings are formed. Basically, our objective is to generate a new characteristic, new set of traits. New set of traits can be generated if we have a different kinds of characteristic. So for example, let us consider 2 8 strings and that is given by 1001111 01, and then another set is 1001010111. Then according to 1 point crossover, if a random crossover point is chosen after 3 bits from left and segments are cut as shown below. So it is, I have described that thing. So here it is at third bit. Okay, so what will happen in the third bit? So after third bit from left. So what will happen? You see, this is 100 and this is your 11101. And this one is after third bit is 010 01011. And so segments which will be actually formed after this crossover, this will be 100. And this particular point is copied here. So this is 01011. And the next one, that is from here, in this case, this is actually kept as it is, 101. And this particular part is copied, that is 11101. So this is copied. Is it clear? Is it clear? Single point crossover, the example?
Yes, sir.
Okay. So according to the 2-point crossover, if 2 crossover points are selected, so let us say there are 2-point crossover in this case. Okay, so single point crossover, it is clear. So 2-point crossover, 10011 and 101. Okay, so 100, 11, and 101. So this is a crossover point. This is another crossover point. Similarly, for this case, 101, then 01, then 011. This is one crossover point. This is another crossover. So then after swapping both the extreme segments, the resulting strings will be, this will be 100. So this will be copied. 01 will be copied here. So 01 is copied and the remaining thing is 101. So that is kept as it is. Then in the second chromosome, 101 is there. So this will be copied. This will be 11. This will be 11 and 011 will be kept as it is. So I will show you the second 2-point crossover also so that you can understand it. So this is a single point crossover. Now 2-point crossover. So let us say there is a crossover which is 2 points. So 2-point crossover, if it is there, so this is, let us say the first parent is 101, 11, 011. This is, let us say, parent one. Then next one is 111, 00, 100. This is your parent two. So here we want to perform the crossover operation. Now you see who will choose? You have to choose that, but how? It is randomly. So what you will write in your program, you have to write two variables. Let us say x1 equal to your rand of, it is, you have to write round. See, it is 8-bit representation. So this would be 8 into round rand 1. What will happen? A random value will be generated, which will be basically rounded. So it will be, you can get either 4, 5, 6 between 0 to 8. So the, you will get between 1 to 8 you will get. Similarly, x2 equal to 8 into round, this is rand of 1. So you will get another number. And if this x1 should not be equal to x2 because you are taking two crossover. So let us say randomly you are getting x1 equal to 3 and x2 equal to, let us say, getting 5. For example, okay, you may get anything. So from here to here, the crossover will start, will basically happen from third bit to the fifth bit. So what will happen? This particular bit characteristic will be copied here. And this particular bit characteristic, it will be copied here. So how the, what will be the structure of the new offspring? We'll see that. What will be the new structure of the offspring? So this will be, the offspring will be first, this will be kept as it is. There will be no change. Now this will be copied. So this will be 100 and this will be 100. So this is your offspring 1. And this one is your 11. And here it is, 111 will be copied. So 111 will be copied and this is 011. So this is your offspring 2. Now, is it clear that how these offsprings are created in the 2-point crossover?
Yes, sir.
So you see the characteristic of the offspring, whatever we have in the parents, it is now changed. So if you compare this one and this one, you see this is, there is a change. And similarly here and here, there is a change in the characteristic. So obviously when we are performing this crossover operation, the characteristic of the parents will be changed. So crossover is not usually applied to all pairs of individuals selected for mating. It is not applied. Okay, a random choice is made where the probability of crossover PC being applied is typically between 0.6 to 0.9. So there is a crossover, probability of crossover. So probability of crossover, we have to see that we have to generate a random number. So if that random number is lying between that particular range, then the crossover operation will be done. So how it is done, I will tell you here. When you write your program, so what has to be written? So generally the crossover probability, the probability of crossover, it is between 0.6 to 0.9. So now you have selected, let us say, 1-point crossover in your problem, 1-point crossover. So when you have chosen this 1-point crossover, so you will generate a random number. Let us say this y equal to a random number, rand of 1, you have selected. Now you are getting this y value after this, if you write in the MATLAB, suppose you have got 0.28. Now we can see this y value, y is less than PC, okay? So what will happen? The crossover will happen or not? Crossover will happen or it will not happen? Yes or no? So here you see the crossover probability is 0.6 to 0.9. Okay, so your Y is less than PC, that is true, but crossover will not happen because the 0.28, it is not lying within 0.6 to 0.9. Similarly, if you are getting a number, let us say Y after random operation, the next cycle you are getting 0.78. Yes, this number, it is within this PC range. So if it is within PC range, then crossover will happen. You have to write your program in such a way so that this particular logic has to be incorporated while you are writing the generic algorithm code. Is it clear?
Yes, sir.
Now, next is the mutation. So mutation is applied to each child individually after crossover. Individually, we have to apply this mutation for. Now, in this case, in case of mutation, we have to understand, in this case, we don't require two offspring. Here, we require only one. Okay, one chromosome is required for performing this particular operation, the mutation operation. So this creates the diversity, because diversity means a new characteristic will be introduced. Basically, the new characteristic will be introduced. It randomly alters each gene with a small probability PM genetic, generally not greater than 0.01. Now, there are different kinds of mutation is there. That is flip bit mutation, boundary mutation, uniform mutation, non-uniform mutation, then Gaussian mutation. So there are different kinds of mutation processes. Now here, how it is done, it is basically a very easy process. I will explain it. It injects a new genetic character into the chromosome by changing at random a bit in a string depending on the probability of the mutation. So for example, the given string is 1011011. Now let us say this particular bit is mutated. So when it is mutated, this 0 will become 1. So this is a change. So the particular bit which is getting mutated, that will be, that bit characteristic will change from 0 to 1 or from 1 to 0. So this is the basically mutation operation. So mutation means a particular bit gets mutated, means it is changing from 1 to 0 or it is from 0 to 1. And with the help of that, we can see the characteristic of the bit characteristic gets changed. So the new traits will be introduced. So new population will have a better offspring, better characteristic will be there, and thereby will be actually the solution quality will be improved. So it is seen in the above example that the 6 bit 0 is changed to 1. So thus in the mutation process, bits are changed from 1 to 0 or to from 0 to 1 at a randomly chosen position of randomly selected strings. So the mutation may be for one individual or a group. So it depends on the type of problem. So let us say this is an original offspring, this offspring 1 and offspring 2. Now here, what will happen, you see here this mutation operation is done. So here, this bit is mutated. So this bit is mutated means from 1 to it becomes 0. Now this bit is mutated in the offspring 2. So what will happen? This particular bit is 0, so this becomes 1. Similarly here, this particular bit is 1, so this becomes 0. So basically, it depends upon the type of problem, whether you want to introduce a new characteristic with the help of mutation operation. So it is very easy. Mutation operation is comparatively easy. So I will just take one example, then you can understand clearly. So mutation, you see, there will be 4 8 bits representation, 10111. Okay. And let us say this is a bit. Okay. This is basically a chromosome. This is a parent one. Now here you want to do the mutation operation. For this particular, I will tell you, let us say here you want to do the mutation operation at fourth bit. And this fourth bit is also, again, it will be chosen randomly. Which bit you want to mutate, that also you will select randomly. So what will happen, the next generation, the offspring which will be created after the mutation, so it will be 100, this will be 0, this will be 100. So the characteristic, this is 100, this is 0, this is 1, this is 1, and this is 1. Okay, this is the characteristic of the offspring. Okay, this is the offspring 1. Okay. Similarly, you have another kind of parent 1101101, and this is parent 2. Okay. Now you want to perform the mutation operation on 2 bits. Okay, 2-bit mutation is you want to perform. On this 3rd bit and on the 7th bit. So 3rd and 7th bit, you want to perform the mutation operation. So what will be that? This will be 1, 1. This will be 0 becomes 1. This will be 1, 1 will be copied, and this 0 will be 1. So this is your offspring 2. So wherever you want to perform the mutation operation, the bit characteristic will change from 0 to 1 or from 1 to 0. Is it clear, that mutation operation?
Yes, sir.
Okay. So what are the advantages and disadvantages of this evolutionary algorithm? So evolutionary algorithm can be efficiently used for highly complex problem with multi-objectivity, non-linearity, etc. It provides not only a single best solution, but the second best, third best, and so on as required. It gives quick approximate solution. EA methods can very well incorporate with the other local search algorithms. So this is basically a highly efficient method. Okay, now what are the differences and similarities between the genetic algorithm and other traditional methods? First is the difference is GA uses coding which discretizes search space even though the function is continuous. Yes, I'm taking class. Yes, please, Ayed. Just a minute, huh? 1 minute. Just a minute. Just wait for 1 minute. Huh? Hello?
Yes, sir.
Okay. Yes. I'm just one person came. I need to. Okay, so there was some interruption. Okay, now we'll continue. What are the differences? So GA uses coding which discretizes search space even though the function is continuous. A discrete function can be handled with no extra cost, works with a population of points instead of singles, so multiple optimal solution can be captured at a time, reducing number of run of algorithm. So search reduction in traditional algorithm is used to find new point, whereas two points are used to define search reduction in a crossover in genetic algorithm. Search reduction is not fixed for all points as mutation works in GA. So these are the something basically some of the basically differences. Now, what are the new characteristic in the different types of GA? Now, there are conventional, there is a genetic algorithm, continuous GA, then there is a binary GA, then the real coded GA, then the NSGA, then Messi GA, parallel GA, multi-objective GA. So there are different kinds of genetic algorithms. So this is something I think this is, and you can easily read it. I don't have to explain. I will just share your this particular thing. There are some application and all those things. So this thing you can actually refer this slide and you can get it. So with this, I will conclude today's lecture, okay? So please write your roll number in the chat box, okay? Because this LMS is not working at this moment. Please write your roll number quickly. Okay, I will copy from there. Quickly you write your roll number so that I can put your attendance. All of you, please write your roll number one by one, okay? So that I can put my your attendance. Now your syllabus for this particular internal test, from my portion, it will be genetic algorithm, okay? So slides and all those things, it is shared with you, okay? And you got the videos also, so you will be getting all this material in the LMS and also the YouTube. So you can refer those videos and you can refer those lecture notes. So with that, I think it will be sufficient for you. So anything, do you have any problem in the lecture notes? Do you have any problem?
No, sir.
Okay, fine. So now all of you have written, na? Your roll number? You have written, so I can copy it now. Okay, so I think it is over. So I will now copy it. Just a minute. So it is starting with Rahul Kumar and it is ending with Shubham Prasad. Is it correct? Chat box. Yes, I think it is correct. Okay. So with this, thank you. I'll close this meeting. Okay. We'll meet in the next class. Thank you to all.
Thank you, sir. Thank you, sir.